2 of the Taste of Mary Farm. Are you guys ready?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go.
Ooh, we're all the way by Calico Mining Co. Could you detonate it? Like, was that a thing? I don't remember.
It looks like you're all somewhat used. Want to try?
COVID. Okay, fine.
Nope.
No. Hey, you just got your hands dirty.
Yep.
Okay, let's go wash your hands.
All right.
This is so cute. Okay, this was one of the treats that I really wanted to try. I thought it was gonna be whipped cream, but it's actually an ice cream cone. And then they put frosting all over and those candy pearls with some frosting, yellow frosting on top for the star. I just realized we forgot to get like a forker spoon. So I will be right back. But this is the butt cake. Then we have the deli turkey sandwich. And we're actually over here by Wilderness Broiler. So this is the deli style turkey. It has brie arugula sandwich with boysenberry cranberry relish. We didn't get the green bean fries because we had that earlier. And I found out what the sauce is. It's a creamy mushroom. That's why it was that good. And the Rudolph's winter pear lemonade with whipped cream and ginger.
Snaps.
All right, guys, let's try the lemonade. Oh, that's pretty good. It's not that citrusy. It tastes like the Ramones prickly pear thing that they had at Carsland. Oh, that's ginger on the side. That's really good.
So like ginger on the rim?
Mm-hmm. I necessarily wouldn't like whipped cream on it, but it's actually not that bad. Oh, this is a 10 out of 10. Definitely good. All right, we got the sandwich. We got the cranberry relish. Hello. The brie should be somewhere right there. What?
Look, the little brie.
That's all you get. As a reminder, for the health and safety of our guests and associates. The fries are pretty cold because they have the sandwiches out, ready to go. So the fries are really cold.
Except when actively eating and drinking in designated areas while stationary.
Okay, so we got the brie there. Some arugula and some relish. We're gonna try not to get any bread.
No bread.
After all the carbs I eat and all there.
It's okay. A little bread won't hurt.
Eat the good carbs. That's pretty good.
Pretty good? But I take a bite of just a little bit of bread. See how the bread is.
That's really good though. Okay, that's a really good sandwich. Something we could do with Thanksgiving leftovers.
Gotcha.
I'm so excited for the mud cake. Please don't let me down. You guys ready? That is some thick frosting.
That looks thick frosting.
Red velvet.
Looks
pretty hard.
Like how spongy it is? The frosting looks like a marshmallow topping type of thing.
Oh yeah, like a marshmallow fluff?
Yeah.
Alright. Here in the light so you guys can see. Ready?
Ready.
It's dry.
Usually bun cakes are dry.
No, but this one's dried. Oh, and that's even drier.
Well, I expected the frosting to be dry. Like, I feel like it's like they have it out, like they decorate, and have it out, they just put it in.
This is a dessert that's good for pictures, but bad for the taste buds. It's not bad, but I wouldn't necessarily get it unless you really want cute pictures with it. Yeah, I would get this one.
Yeah.
This one? I would skip it.
I had a feeling it looked like just only that for decoration.
I had high hopes for this one.
Aww.
You gotta try it.
Alright, I'll try it.
Alright guys, so we went over to G.
Who?
And that is the Silver Bullet booth. And they have a bunch of stuff that we already had. But I've been wondering how the pineapple cider tastes like. Because we had the pumpkin one and it was delicious.
Yeah.
Oh, that's really good.
You think it's by the same company?
By Ace Cider?
Yeah.
Could be. That's delicious. It's crisp. There's not a lot of like pineapple taste.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit, but it's so good. It's refreshing. It's crisp. It's kind of sweet. Oh, this is good. I have a feeling it's probably by the same I'm not a drinker. You guys are like bikes.
We're proving it right here.
No, I'm not a drinker, and especially I don't drink ciders or beers. But this is good. Sometimes I make the exception, but this is really good.
All right, side note, I want to make a little rant. All right, they check your ID. That's fine, but the whole system, the point was they have that they check your ID once and you have the ID check. Mm-hmm. So they no longer have to check your ID. So why do you keep checking ID? There's nothing wrong, but it kind of ruins the inconvenience or ruins the
easiness.
The system or easy way. So basically, it's no point of having the ID check if they check your ID all the time.
I feel like opening day weekend, they're kind of like all over the place.
Yeah.
Because we did go back to, what's it called?
Sutter's Grill.
And we were able to get another card, and we were able to use the pass holder discount this time. But yeah, everything's like all over the place today.
There's Christmas stuff! I kind of want the hoodie! This is cute! Oh, I'm gonna drop stuff. Oh, this is cute!
Christmas stuff? You put it on your shoulder or no? Oh no, just Woodstock.
It's a magnetic one.
And there's Snoopy. Can you see some Christmas stuff?
There's the Christmas Snoopy. Let's see the shirts. Actually, let's go see the sweatshirts. Oh, thank you. They won't let you. You know what? I think if they had like a long sleeve, I would get in a heartbeat.
I thought it was a long sleeve.
Look at my girl.
That's so cool. We're over here at Camp Snoopy. And there are characters you can meet over there, so I don't think we're gonna go meet anyone because we're still gonna go get more food. This is so crazy, we've never been here. We didn't even know this was a restaurant. Alright, we're gonna get the turkey dinner big bites, the Knott holiday bowl. Hey guys, start either at Sutter's Grill or at Grizzly Creek Lodge. This is so festive right here. This is Camp Snoopy, you guys. We're getting the feels of Yosemite. We're getting the feels of Christmas. Oh my God, everything here looks so pretty. And I gotta say that the employees over here at Grizzly are super nice. They're super sweet. So, I mean, it was great here. We got the Knott's Holiday Bowl that has chicken tenders, gravy, mashed corn stuffing, and cranberry sauce. So it's kind of like a Thanksgiving in a bowl.
Yep.
And these are so cute. We got the turkey dinner big bites. I was expecting corn dogs or something.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think that's what I was expecting. And we got a hot apple cider. I'm really excited for that. By the way, this is not alcoholic. And the big winner, I have high hopes for this one since the butt cake let me down. This one right here is the chocolate peppermint cheesecake bar with white chocolate and peppermint bark. So I love me some peppermint. I love me some cheesecake. Let's hope this one's better than the cheesecake we had at Sutter's and the bun cake.
Okay.
I'm excited. Oh, let me start with that side.
Okay.
Is it sweet?
Is it sweet or not sweet?
It doesn't taste sweetened. If it's not that sweet, I'll be happy. Because
yep.
I've had a lot of sugar today.
Hey, sweet.
I'm going to start with the bowl.
It's okay.
So mashed potatoes, chicken nuggets, corn, gravy, and a little side of cranberry sauce. Get a bite of everything. Go. Tastes like a cake and a sea bowl. With cranberries off. I'm excited for these. And the fries are a little cool. But these are warm.
Alright,
ready? Ooh, they're steamy. Oh, that smells good. That smells like real turkey.
Not turkey bowl?
No, I don't know if you guys can see. One side of gravy.
Oh, cool.
These are good. That is so good. I feel like this would be an appetizer for Thanksgiving.
Yeah?
These are so good. So there's real, there's turkey in there, there's stuffing, there's something sweet. I wonder if they put, I wonder if they put something sweet in there, like cranberry or something. I don't see any sauce. These are really good. 10 out of 10. Yeah, it's still not sweet enough. I wonder if maybe they're almost out and they just like diluted it. Just yeah.
Yeah, probably.
It has the hint of apple cider, but without the sweetness to it.
Gotcha.
I'm not hating it. All right. Here's the moment of truth. The cheesecake bar, white chocolate and peppermint bark. Doesn't smell peppermint.
Does it?
It's really good.
Really good?
Mm-hmm. The crust is Oreo.
Oh, cool. Did it beat your expectations?
This is better than the cheesecake from Sutter's.
Okay.
Get this one.
Yeah.
Oh, there is a hint of peppermint in there. It's subtle. It's subtle peppermint. So if you're not a fan of peppermint, don't be afraid. It's very subtle. You get a small hint of it. It's really good. I gotta say, I think this is one of my favorites.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. We should have started here.
I know, right? But I think it's good to start right now.
Now you guys know, start Camp Soupy. And they also have the Christmas tree bun cake here.
Yeah.
But they do have it here because there's two areas. There's the Grizzly and then there's one over here. We're going to go check out what they have in this one. And then we'll see what else because we're pretty stuffed.
Yep.
We're almost done with the list too.
Oh really? I thought we're still missing some stuff.
There's a lot of booths that have repeats.
Yeah.
So it does look like there's a lot of food, but a lot of the booths do have a lot of repeats. So just keep an eye on that. That way you guys can go to one place and then get everything that you want instead of going
booth to booth.
It saves you time.
Yeah.
Before the lens fogs, I can show you that there's a little cinnamon stick in there. And you went foggy. But there's cinnamon in there. It's actually pretty good.
It's so festive here, guys. So pretty. They did such a cute job here at Knott's Berry Farm. We're gonna go see if we can take a picture with Snoopy over there. Today is National Gingerbread Cookie Day.
So we came over to Fiesta Village, and over Fiesta Dog, we got the pozole. Now we normally don't add cilantro or lime to ours. We do add cabbage or lettuce, but you can notice that you didn't put lime, so I'm sorry.
Oh.
All right, let's try it.
But one thing we do put is radish.
Yeah. All right, so there's pork, and then there's the maíz or corn that's used. Let's see if it's good. It's a little cold.
A little cold?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's I feel like a lot of their food has been sitting out. Just so they can make it easier. It's definitely not bad. Just use my hands. But we do add onion, but not cilantro.
Yeah.
You guys see that? All right, let's get a bite with everything. There you go. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not bad.
Yeah.
The cilantro gives it a different taste. If it was warmer, it would have been better.
Gotcha.
It's like a 9 out of 10.
Cool.
Oh. Yum. You like pozole a lot.
Yeah. So, do we compare it as original or no? Like a real...
There's my mom's.
Okay, so like it doesn't taste like authentic.
Mm-hmm.
That's, I think, the more important, just to taste authentic.
Mm-hmm. It just has an interesting flavor with the cilantro. Mm. Because we don't eat it with cilantro.
Yeah.
And we've uncovered the great mystery. Hollywood Hits, Coaster Diner, Boardwalk, Cantina in Fiesta Village, and Sutter's Grill in Ghost Town are the only places you can buy the tasting cart.
Gotcha.
So this might change throughout the festival, but so far this is what we found. We've been asking everywhere. And that's our research.
Yep.
Hopefully this helps you guys.
Yeah.
Alright, you gotta get on this.
Alright, I will.
We're gonna go meet Snoopy!
Thank you!
That's it, guys. Thank you so much for joining us for the Taste of Mary Farm. We had an amazing time. We ate a lot. We drank a lot. Oh, it was such a great evening. It's definitely a great festival. I feel like maybe the Taste of Halloween was a little better than this one. I feel like the organization was better, but the portions in this festival, they're massive. They are like full-size portions. But we had such a great time. Did you have fun?
Yes, I did.
It was very merry, special, and it was great. Great job, Knott. The food was delicious. Those turkey bites were fantastic. We just had a great time. So happy Thanksgiving to all of you guys, and we'll be seeing you soon on our next adventure. Bye.
Bye. Merry Christmas, everyone. And Thanksgiving. Don't forget Thanksgiving, please.
Okay, guys, so we were only missing a couple more items. We got really, really full. We couldn't finish everything, but I did go on Monday back to the Taste of Mary Farm with the Parks Palette, and I got to try a couple more items, and our friend Kat came with us, so make sure you read the description box. I will be rating the foods down there as well.
Can get together. There's nothing sweeter or finer. When it's nice and cold, I can hold my baby closer to me and collect the kisses that are due me. I love the winter weather, 'cause I got my love to keep me warm.
All right, guys, I highly recommend that raspberry and chocolate cookie witch sandwich. It is amazing. Thanks again for joining us in another adventure, and we'll be seeing you guys soon. Don't forget to check us out on Instagram. Bye. Fun.